Welcome back to the sanctuary. Pray with us.
With a grateful heart, Lord, we come into your courts. All we need is you. Touch our hearts and dwell within it. Set our hearts on fire with your spirit.
With a grateful heart, Lord, My name is Deacon Bowens, one of your servants of the week, along with Deacon Eddie Strickland. God is truly blessing us today. It's good to be back in the house one more time. Some want to be here but can't be here, but Lord allowed us to see this day to come to his house, and that's a blessing by itself. If we now stand for a moment of prayer. Oh, gracious and heavenly Father, we come to you with bowed down heads and humble hearts, Father. Father, we yet come just to say thank you right now. We want to thank you, Father, for life, health, and strength right now, Father. Father, we thank you right now for what you're about to do in our life and what you already done, Father. If you don't do nothing else today, we want to say thank you right now for what you have did, Father. We bless your name right now, Father. We ask you to bless the bishop this time, Father. As he preached, we hear a word from you, Father. Father, we hear a word from you today, Father, that may save a soul somewhere, Father. But we're going to lift up your name, Father. We're lifting up your name because you are worthy to be lifted up this morning, Father. You are worthy of all praises that you give, Father. And we thank you right now for the ministers. We thank you right now for the deacons. We thank you right now, Father, that you touch each and every one of them right now. In the name of Jesus, Father. Touch the ones that are on the way to your house right now, Father. Touch them right now, Father. Let them, you'll be a pilot and not the co-pilot, Father. But we thank you right now for this church, Hopewell, right now, Father. Father, we ask you to touch our choirs right now, Father. We just want to lift your name right now, Father. We want to lift your name, Father. We thank you for your grace and your mercy, Father. Father, we thank you for your grace and your mercy, Father. We thank you for going to Calvary for us, Father, because we couldn't do it, but you did it, Father. You shed your blood on Calvary, Father. Father, we thank you right now. We bless your name. In the mighty name of Jesus, we say amen. Our scripture will be coming from Psalms 100. You all have it, say amen. Make a joyful noise. Shout to the Lord. Make Lord. All ye land, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. He is who made us and not we ourselves. That's a blessing right there. We are his peoples, the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Amen. It's time for our altar call.
Come on, it's altar call. A time when you can come and bring your cares, whatever your concerns may be this morning. There's healing at the altar. There's delivering it at the altar. Hallelujah to your name. Whatever your concerns are, you can bring them. Shackles are loose here at the altar. Burdens are lifted. Captives are set free. Chains are broken. He said, cast your cares upon me. It's altar call. Thank you, Lord. He's waiting with arms stretched wide just to hear your cares and your needs. All heads bowed. God, you are wonderful. God, you are sovereign. God, you are all we need. So this morning, God, we come to tell you thank you. Thank you for your goodness. God, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. God, we come this morning, God, with bowed down heads. Some come with hurt on their hearts this morning. But God, we know that you are a lifter of a bowed down head. So this morning, God, we lift up our heads and we lift up our eyes unto the hill for which cometh our help. We thank you right now, Lord God. Father God, whatever the need of your people have come to the altar this morning, we know when they return to their seats, it's already done, because we come believing and trusting in your name. God, we thank you this morning. God, some come with a sick report right now, but we know that you to be a healer right now in the name of Jesus. God, some come with concerns on their heart, but you said that you would perfect whatever concerns us. So right now we give you praise and we give you glory. God, whatever the needs in the household right now, God, meet them at their needs right now in the name of Jesus. God, whether it be financial right now, you say you'll be money in the bank for us, God. You will lead us, God. God, some come with just a report to give you praise and give you honor for what you've done for them already this week. So God, we lift up your to the hills right now, God. God, we thank you right now. God, where there's joy, give them joy right now in their hearts. Where there's peace, give them peace that surpasses all understanding. Because we're going to keep our minds stayed on you. God, we ask that you reduce high blood pressure right now in the name of Jesus. Diabetes has to be gone in the name of Jesus. God, touch them right now. Somebody's standing in need of a job right now, God. But come this week, God, you're going to give them just what they need. God, we thank you. God, bless our pastor right now, Lord God, who's going to bring the bread of life right now, God. Continue to bless him from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet, Lord Jesus. Bless our assistant pastor right now. Give him the same unction of the Holy Ghost. Give our youth pastor the same unction of the Holy Ghost, Lord God. Give them wisdom. Give them knowledge to lead the people, Lord God. And God, as we return to our seats, we're going to turn in victory. And we're going to shout hallelujah to your name, because it's already done. Because we believe and we trust in you. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
welcome to your Father's house. If you would please stand with us as we prepare for our morning reading. Our responsive reading will come from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, reading responsively verses 23 through 26. Every Sunday, with the exception of the first Sunday of the month, Pastor Shields or the assistant pastor will partake of the Lord's Supper for the church body. An observance admonished by Jesus Christ in scriptures to do often in remembrance of him. And because we remember Jesus every day, every Sunday this observance will take place. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. Congregation. After the same manner also, he passed the cup when he had supped, saying, "This is the cup. This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me." All together. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death until he comes. There in the upper room, the Lord took the bread, he blessed it, broke it, and passed it among them, and said, "Eat, this is my body, which is broken for you." And in the same manner, he passed the cup. "This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. Thank you, Jesus, for your sacrifice." Our doxology is holy, holy, holy.
How many of you guys know we serve a great big God?
Yes, we do. During our worship service today. God bless you.
Amen. Would all of our first-time guests and visitors please stand and let us greet you? Amen. There's a gentleman in the rear and some folks over here to our right. On behalf of our senior pastor, Bishop William L. Shields, we greet you with the love of Christ and thank you for coming to worship with us this morning. You'll receive a visitor's card and a Let's Get Acquainted card. Please fill that out. Return that in the offering container, as well as receive hugs from Hopewell members who are near you. Amen. We'll now move to our screen announcements.
Our annual Hopewell Angel Tree season is finally here, and now that we have selected those families in need, Hopewell needs you. If you desire to put some Christmas joy in a child's life, why not sponsor a child or a family this year? Simply sign up in the Information Center after each service today, or you can contact Sister Happy at the church office at 770-448-5475, and we will match you with a child or a family. We are also in need of $25 gift cards from Walmart, Target, or Kroger, in addition to gas cards from QT. Just drop them off at the church office. Hopewell, get involved and give to a child or a family in need this year. No one travels through life without at some point experiencing the loss of someone or something dear. The loss of a loved one through death is one of life's most intense challenges, and the pain can be overwhelming, but God will not leave you to suffer alone. The Hopewell Spiritual Care and Counseling Ministry will host a grief and loss session on Monday, November the 18th, starting at 7 p.m. in Faith Hall. Dr. Catrice Glenn, Hopewell's Counseling Center Director, will lead this session. This gathering will discuss ways to cope with grief and the physical, emotional, and spiritual response to loss. If you are in need, we hope you will attend.
It's that time of year again, Hopewell. Time for the annual Thanksgiving dinner. God intended for us to fellowship with one another, so why not come and break bread together with your sisters and brothers in Christ? But don't come empty-handed. Bring a dish or two to share. Don't just stop there. Why not volunteer through serving? Great volunteers are needed to make this a successful event. If you're interested in volunteering through serving, simply sign up during Wednesday night Bible study at the back table or in the information center at the each service today. If you would rather donate a dish to share with others, you can sign up for that too. So join us for this year's Thanksgiving dinner, because there's always room at the table.
Visit and share our all-new website, www.hmbchurch.net, for all things Hopewell, like online giving, live Sunday and special service online streaming, and viewing past services online on demand. And finally, be encouraged daily by liking, following, and sharing us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Today, the WOW Choir, who is awesomely singing in the rear, have been having the Soul Food fundraiser, and they still have some desserts available. So after worship service, before you go home, head upstairs to Faith Hall to get some cookies and cake, and there may even be some pies left, all right? If you got a sweet tooth, you want something to help you with dinner this afternoon, stop by upstairs before you leave and purchase a dessert from our wonderful WOW Choir for their fundraiser. This coming Friday, the 15th, we are asking all Hopewell youth and their friends to come out to Sky Zone in Suwannee for our November fellowship. We will be at Sky Zone starting at 7 p.m. We ask you to get there a little bit early. The first 100 students to register get in for just $5. Amen. So you need to go ahead and go online. If you look in your bulletin, you'll see all the registration information in there. Go ahead and register so that we can get everybody in at that $5 rate as quickly as possible. And then it'll be $10 after that. Okay? Lastly, for the youth ministry, we are doing a blanket and winter clothing drive for the month of November. One of the things that we're making sure that we instill in our young people is to pay attention to those who are in need and to do things to help ease the burden of your brother or sister. And so we have asked our young people to bring in blankets, gently used warm clothing items such as coats, scarves, gloves, socks, all of those type things so that we may take them to a unhoused person shelter later this month. We have a container in the information center upstairs. We also have one in the youth church. So please encourage your young people and you as well, please bring in some of those winter clothing items so we may be a blessing to someone else. Lastly, from my other role as the director of our counseling center here at Hopewell, you saw on the announcements we are holding a Dealing with Grief and Loss session on Monday the 18th, beginning at 7 p.m. I want to make one addition. We've invited an author who does work around the loss of a parent to come to that session as well. She's also a therapist. And so we're encouraging you, it is open and free to the public. If you have coworkers or friends or family who could benefit from coming to this session, we encourage you to just send everybody. Amen? Okay, amen. We will now have ministry from our dance ministry. ready for you. Old Bishop, come by now.
Good morning. Oh, wow. Wow's not on us. Let me ask, okay, is there any food left over from desserts? Okay, well, Wow has desserts. They had a full menu between services. But if you want some excellent potato pie, apple pie, mud pie, blueberry pie, green berry pie, red berry pie, then go to Faith Hall afterwards, and WOW has it available. Amen. God bless you. Let's continue with our services. If the seats are a little warm, it's because on the front of your bulletin, you see what happened in here. The first service, the church caught on fire. Church on fire. So now, if you don't want to catch on fire, you know, Pastor Davis will grab his head and slap on the podium here, then you're in the wrong place. God bless you. Hey, bring the fire with you. That's what I'm talking about. Let's do this really quickly. Bible study has resumed, as you know, and Wednesday night was, well, not resumed, but started a new lesson plan from the book of Acts, Acts chapter 1. We're going chapter 1 through 5. In chapter 1, we got about 50% through, same, about the church, the first church, the church that was on fire. So then God has orchestrated this to make sure it falls in line, that not only are we teaching about the church on fire, but we also preaching about the church on fire. I wanted to have additional mantles to share with those of you who didn't touch or receive one. But then there was a back order on same. So then when I get it, then we'll make them available. But God didn't want it to happen. He wanted to make sure that the mantles that fell on Sunday and are still falling, and that the church catch on fire and be purged, and that God fans the floor. And we'll talk about that in the sermon. Amen. Today is Veterans Day. Well, all the veterans, please stand up. All military veterans, please stand. Let us recognize you. And please remain standing. Give God a praise offering for same. Yet. We had about 40 veterans at the first service. Now you may be seated. I'm going to ask your service, the division of service that you served in, all those who were in the Navy stand. Okay, we had several in the Navy this morning. And Air Force, Army. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Marines. Something happened. Charles, something happened to those Marines. They still, I don't know. They can be 70, 80 years old, like Elder Davis, and still be walking around barking and carrying on. I was in the Army. It was anyone that were officers in your military. I was a second lieutenant in the Army. Any one of you are officers in the military? Well, let's go on with the military. Air Force with the Air Force, Navy, Army, Coast Guard, Reserves, Boy Scout, Girl Scouts. ROTC. Wait a minute, remain standing, ROTC. I forgot to do that this morning. Whoa. ROTC. You may be seated now. You know, the most joyful and the most resounding was the ROTC. I don't believe that. But that's a good thing. God bless you real good. Election day, thank you for going out to the polls. Here in Norcross, Mayor Craig Newton won by a landslide for re-election. Re-election by a landslide, over 60% of the vote. Major Weaver in Duluth got most of the votes. He got the majority, but he did not get enough to prevent a runoff. So he's in runoff for his seat, and we believe that that he's going to secure his seat with the runoff. We'll give you the date, those who live in Johns Creek. Those who wedding anniversaries in the month of November, stand, please. In the wedding anniversary, we had, there were so many in this morning. We should have counted the number. How many of you estimate in green? There were 12 couples. 12 couples, the largest number we've ever had for anniversaries. And those of you who are standing, happy anniversary to you. We still have to give you, just give them a little serenade. Just remain standing. If your spouse is not with you, then hug yourself. If your spouse is with you, turn and hug each other. Bless you. Happy anniversary to the couples, please. And now let's do birthdays, and we will redeem the time, a good time. Thank you, dancers, for that awesome routine that you did today with the alabaster boxes. Thank you. And when you stood up on that one leg for an extended amount of time, I was sitting on the steps at the first service. We saw you on the monitor in my upper room. And for a long time, long, long time, like this. Oh, like this. And this is how you do it lower, like this. Birthdays, please, for the month of November. All birthday babies, if you're 18 and under, come across the front. If you are in the pews, come to the edge of the pews, please. All November birthdays, please stand. An enormous amount of them for the first service. So, wow. We didn't get many. Iris Bell, you ought to come to the edge here because they didn't go across it. Come to the edge here, okay. All right, come on, babies. If you're 18 and under, come on down. Oh. Start this off with you, right there. Turn around, face. Okay, you got on your cutest pumpkin in the patch. Oh. Come over here, sir. How old are you? You're about to turn 37.
13.
Oh. You almost said that. He said I'm about to turn 37. 13. All right. And how old are you? 30.
Four.
Oh, 40. Kids can say the dirtiest things. Let me do that. Okay, I'll try this again. How old are you?
Four.
Okay. How old are you?
Six.
Okay. How old are you?
18.
How old are you?
18.
Golly, how y'all get to be 18? That means you're going to graduate next year, right? Bless you. It's a good thing to be in the choir on your birthday, isn't it? Because you get double pay. All right. Let's do this, please, for birthdays. One, two, one, two. Hit me.
Let me see your bones.
Amen. Let us prepare. Let us prepare our tithe and offering envelopes. Trustees, would you please come as we prepare for our time of giving?
Let us all stand. Father, we thank you for this opportunity once again to give into this house that is set aside, Lord God, for us to come in and praise and lift up your holy name, Lord God. Father, we thank you for just waking us up this morning, closing our right mind, giving us a brand new day. Lord, we just honor you with praise and worship. And Lord, we just give you all the praise and all the glory. And Father, you said, give and it shall be given unto you. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall men give unto your bosom. So Father, as the peoples come to give today, I pray that they come with a cheerful heart, Lord God, knowing that you are Lord of all. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
just receive these gifts, these tithes, these offerings, oh God, and bless those today who had a heart to give, oh God. Father, we thank you for your grace, your mercy, and your love. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, babies, for song services. Thank you, musicians. Thank God. Will you bow your heads right where you are? I want to pray a prayer of total praise. Total praise prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Holy God, our Father who art in heaven, holy is thy name, holy reverend God, we praise you today with our hearts and songs. We praise you for your faithfulness. We praise you for your great power and love. We confess our need for you. Our lives don't go well when we just spin around in circles and try to do it on our own. We struggle and worry. We get weary and worn. Yet you never leave us nor forsake us. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your care over us. Thank you for your healing blessings, spiritual, physical, financial healings. Thank you that you breathe renewal right into our souls. We ask for your spirit to fill us, to draw us close to yourself, and to work your purposes through us as we set our eyes on you. It is in Jesus' name we offer to you total praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Every saint of God say amen. Amen. God bless you real good. Come now, let us reason together. Isaiah 10 and Hebrews chapter 1. One verse from each scripture, Isaiah 10, 27 and Hebrews 1, 7. Isaiah 10, 27, Hebrews chapter 1, verse 7. Reading Isaiah first, please. And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. And the yoke, read that again, beginning at the conjunction and, please. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Read that one more time, please. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. It's the anointing that destroys the yoke. Hebrews 1, 7, and of the angels, he saith, who maketh his angels spirits and his ministers a flame of fire. And now we're going to start at the conjunction and again. This is clergy ministers and lay ministers. And his ministers a flame of fire. Our title is, Can You Handle the Fire? You may be seated. Last Sunday, it was, Can You Handle the Mantle? Today is, Can You Handle the Fire? And if I were to choose a subtitle will be, Don't Touch Me, I'm on Fire. A cross-reference for this text is 1 John chapter 2, verse 20. The cross reference is, but ye have an unction from the Holy One, and ye know all things. We're going to delineate between anointing or baptism and the special power unction in the midst of the sermon. In Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 13 through 14, as you see on the front of your bulletins, the church on fire, you can lift that from Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 13 through 14. And then as we read it, I will expound on it or make it plain. Reading, please. As for the likeness of the living creatures, this is Ezekiel writing this vision that he saw. I'm going to make it plain. Watch this. He said, as for the likeness of the living creatures, their appearance was like burning coals of fire. Living creatures, their appearance was like coals of fire. And like the appearance of lamps, it went up and down among the living creatures. The fire went up and down among the living creatures. And the fire was bright, and out of the fire went forth lightning. The 14th verse, and the living creatures ran and returned as the appearance of a flash of lightning. What Ezekiel saw was the saints of God on fire, entering into worship, exiting worship, and coming back into worship like flashes of lightning on fire. The intensity of lightning going in and out of the worship service. Let me help us today. Notice that these living creatures came into worship on fire, left worship on fire, returned back into worship on fire. Like lightning, they came in and out of the worship on fire. Saints of God, we must enter into the service as God say, enter into my gates with thanksgiving, before my courts with praise. We must enter in on fire. You must bring the fire. Don't wait to be set on fire. Now I'm gonna tell you how you bring the fire. I'm gonna watch this. Jesus Christ, bring the fire. And now you'll see how you can bring the fire in a moment here. Luke 3, verses 16 through 17. John answered, saying unto them all, I indeed baptize you with water, but one mightier than I cometh, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to unloose. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. 17th verse that we don't understand as much, and I'm going to break it down for you in the midst of the sermon. Whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and will gather the wheat into his barns. But the chaff he will burn with fire unquenchable. And watch this. In three separate scriptures, God is referred to specifically as a consuming fire. Deuteronomy 4:24, Deuteronomy 9:3, and Hebrews 12:29. These three scriptures specifically identifies God as a consuming fire. Our God, saints, our God is a consuming fire. Hebrews 1:7 says in our cross-reference scripture, and of the angels he saith, who maketh his angels spirits and his ministers a flame of fire. I'm going to ask a question today in this brief sermon. Are there any flames in the house right now? Well, all of you should have applauded or jumped it up and shouted, because all of you have the fire. All of you have been gifted with the fire. Well, let me teach it and it'll help you get there. Watch this. We gather from these scriptures and many others that our God is a God of fire, and that everything associated with Jehovah God has fire connected to it, which includes all of us. On the day of Pentecost, every head got a flame. The problem is, and the trouble is here in the 21st century is, and the question is, can you handle the flame? If you can't handle the flame, it's just like carrying a 10-pound Bible under your arm, but you don't know what's in the Bible. It's not the word under your arm the devil fears. It's the word in your heart that becomes the sword of the Spirit, that becomes flames of fire. on the day of Pentecost, cloven tongues like as fire set upon each of them, the 120 men and women, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Please stay with me here. The point I'm making is two things happened on that day. Number one, they got tongues. Number two, they got fire. When the Holy Ghost came, he came as a rushing mighty wind. But not only as a rushing mighty wind can it, but also as fire. In the mind of God, they came together on the day of Pentecost. Watch this. They came together on the day of Pentecost, and God gave two powerful manifestations. He gave them tongues of fire, and then he gave them tongues on fire. Tongues of fire, Minister Bell, and tongues on fire. But religion, I didn't say Christianity, I said religion. What's this, Angie? But religion has done a pretty good job of separating the two. But let me merge the two now. If the Holy Ghost baptism is anything, it is a baptism of fire. If Pentecost is anything, it is a baptism of fire. The question is to us today, Hopewellians, can we handle the fire? If the Holy Ghost in your life means anything, it means that you have already received power. The Bible says, ye shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost is come upon you. So you are sitting in the midst of this service with power and with fire. Ye shall receive power. I Google power, and power means force. Power means ability. Power means strength. Power means miraculous power. Power means balance. So there's a disturbance going on the inside of you that you can't keep to yourself. But when you do smother it, you are quenching the power of the Holy Ghost, and that's a sin. This is what happens when you are baptized with the Holy Ghost and fire. Supernatural force and abilities rise up in you. Strength takes over your life. Miraculous power comes inside of you. Like a volcano, a volcano never dies. You never hear those who are meteorologists or those who are Scientologists or those who are study volcanoes. They never say that the volcano is dead. They will say that it's dormant or it's lying at rest. But let me help you today. So the volcano that God has given you from the inside, it never goes out. It never dies, but many of us have allowed it to become dormant. Many of us have allowed it to be burned on low. Many of us have quenched the fire. But let me tell you, it's still there smothering, and like a volcano, it wants to explode. That's why sometimes some of us get kind of fidgety in your pew, and you rock a little bit, and you look around, see who's watching you a little bit, and because the volcano wants to explode, Connie, it wants to be turned loose, but you just kind of. And then you rock a little bit, and you rock forward a little, and you wave your hand a little bit, and you say, "Amen, Pastor." But actually, Judge Leary, the volcano wants to explode into a praise worship and wants to set everything around you on fire, but Kim, beginning with you. They want to burn, consume you from the inside. Somebody ought to say amen right there. The fire of God is an energizing force. If you want energy, real energy, put down the energy drinks and allow the energy that's on the inside of you to be released, and you'll find out how much energy you really have. Those who ask me, Papa Shields, how do you have energy all the time? You're just bouncing here, bouncing all the stuff. Well, that's because I have a supernatural energy on the inside, and I don't keep it to myself. I just allow it to be released, and when it's released, I get that I can't help it. My feet won't be still. My body won't be still. I got to walk it out. I got to preach it out. I got to pray it out. I got to shout it out. I got to worship it out. And I don't hold it to myself because I got a volcano on the inside that I allow to erupt in every situation, whether I'm in church or whether I'm in the line at the bank or whether I'm driving all alone by myself, when I'm sitting in my study at home, when the volcano started erupting, I just let it out. I just scream out and say, bless you, Father, for you are good. Thank you for your consuming fire. Those standing remain standing. I'm going to close right here. Watch. This fire from God is a sanctifying and purifying agent as well. Now, I told you I was going to explain John. What John said, his fan is in his hand. The fan is in God's hand. Watch this, minister. And he will thoroughly purge his floor. I know you want to explain that, so don't go to sleep on this right now. His floor. What is his floor? He fanning his floor. What is his floor? His floor is where God walks. And God walks in you. God walks in me. So God purges his floor, because he's not going to walk on mess. He purges his floor. He cleans it. Before he sets the house on fire, he purges. He cleans. He purges. He fans his floor. He gets it clean. And he says, before I come over here and walk around in you, I got to clean the floor. And when I clean the floor, then I'm going to get up and walk all around in you. And I'm going to set you on fire with a consuming fire that you can't keep to yourself. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, don't touch me. I'm on fire. Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. First Corinthians 6:19. Watch this, minister. Get to me. When the Holy Ghost comes, and where the Holy Ghost lives and where he rules, he will clean his house. And when he cleans his house, Minister Lisby, he sets it on fire. It's a purging, and then it's a purifying. He doesn't purify, then purge. He sweeps and then he sets it on fire. Shoot. Shields, you teaching this. Sometimes the fire on the inside is so hot, I can barely stand it myself. And I've been set on fire for 46 years. But sometimes I can't stand it. I can barely stand it. I just want to say, Elder Wynn, don't touch me. I'm on fire. I can't lose. I don't say don't touch me because I lose my anointing. You can't lose your anointing. God gives you the anointing. You can't lose that. But sometimes my fire is burning so hot, I don't want somebody just touch me, because then you quench it for a minute. But as soon as I feel my fire burning down, I get away from that quencher. I said, no, you are a quencher. You're not an enhancer. You're not putting any kindle on this fire. You're not putting any fuel on my fire. I love you, but I'm going to love you across over here somewhere, because I don't want you to quench what I got. I don't want it to quench what I got. Sometimes my fire causes my flesh to crawl. Anytime you scratching, ain't nothing itching. Anytime, First Pete, you just feel something all over you, Christian. You said, Lord, have mercy
say, what's going on here? Let me tell you what's going on there. There's a fire on the inside that want to come on the outside, and you get the I can't help it sometimes, and sometimes you just get up and you just get a little dance on, you get a praise on. That's the fire of the Holy Spirit that's moving in your life, and you can't quench that fire. You must be a child of fire, because the God we serve is a God of fire. Watch this. You know what the Holy Spirit will do for you if you release him. I want some Baptist people in here to help me. I want some Baptist, because the church was born on the day of Pentecost. I have any Baptist people in the house today? It's a Baptist people. Some of those filled with the Holy Ghost and with fire. You know what would happen? The Holy Spirit will glorify Jesus in your life. You will be able to put the devil under your foot. You will have power over habits, bondages, and addictions. God doesn't want us addicted to anything except the anointing. He will give you power to be a great witness. He will give you power to help others. He will make you a blessing for other people. He will be a channel through which the miracle of life, power of God, will flow through you, and your fire will burn with intensity that those who want to be around you, those who have fire as well, when you come together, then there's not a bonfire, there's a volcano fire. You know the saying that iron sharpens iron, but fire intensifies fire. So if you want your fire intensified, hook up with somebody who's already on fire. Then when you get together, then your fire will be a perfect fire, 7 times hotter than it's ever been before. John said in John chapter 7, verses 37 and 38, out of your bellies will flow rivers of living water. You will become partners with Jesus in the Great Commission, Mark 16, verses 16 through 18. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. Here it is right there, verse 17. And these signs, I've been preaching this about these signs all year long. And these signs, I'm talking about believers in the signs and wonders of God. These signs, are there any believers in the house? Are there any flames in the house? And these signs shall follow them that believe in my name. Shall they cast out devils, and they shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up deadly stuff. They shall drink. You got nothing can harm you, because you have been set on fire by the fire of God. Anything that's in his temple that shouldn't be there, allow him to fan it and fan the fire until you consume lupus and cancer and diabetes and high blood pressure and all those things that don't belong in the temple of God. Because when the church is on fire, it's purified from the inside out. You are the church that's making up this sacred assembly. So turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, will you help my fire burn? I'll help your fire burn. And together we shall consume anything that is not of God. And I close. When you are on fire for God, you are a threat to hell. You are a threat to people around you who are not on fire. You said, I didn't do anything to Sister Roundtree. Why is she always messing with me? That's because you're a threat. Why is this lady that? You're a threat. Why is she rolling eyes at me? You're a threat. Why is she talking about me all the time? You're a threat. Why? I just walked into, Sister Nurse, I just walked into the lab. I just walked into the hospital, and they start talking. I hear them whispering, and when I walk up, they stop talking. That's because they were talking about you. That's because you are a threat. If you're a threat to the devil, you're a threat to the agitators, you're a threat to hell because you are a threat. When your fire comes in, you are a threat. And when that threat is intensified, don't you fight it with flesh and blood. Don't fight it with flesh and blood. When that threat comes and the lies come against you, you just take it to the Lord in prayer and tell God, intensify my fire. I want you to consume me, then consume what's trying to bother me. Father, I want you to set it on fire right now. A lukewarm Christian is a better advertisement for the devil than for God. Because our God is a consuming fire. The fire, ask your neighbor, can you feel the fire? Let me tell you this, some of you are going to leave here today and the devil isn't going to know what to do with you because you are going to be too hot to handle. Maybe I'm going to say that. When you leave here today, said the devil won't know what to do with you. Because, Rachel, he's going to say you're too hot to handle. Brooks, your testimony is too hot to handle. Your healing is too hot to handle. Your walk is too hot to handle. Your body language is too hot to handle. Your speech is too hot to handle. Your prosperity is too hot to handle. Everything you do is too hot to handle. You got your back squared up. You got your shoulder square, and you walking like you're somebody. Yes, you are somebody. You are somebody. Taja, you just too hot to handle. He can't handle you. He can't, Madison, he can't handle you when you're filled with the Holy Ghost and fire. You are a power to be reckoned with. And I thank God that the devil hates me and tries to destroy me, but he can't handle this. You know why? Because he can't touch me because I'm on fire. Jesus went to Calvary. He died for our sin. He rose with all power. And that same power is on the inside of us. But you can't quench the power. You can't quench the fire. You got to let the fire burn with intensity. You are somebody. Don't worry about who's in the White House. That rascal is just a pawn used by the glory of God. Don't worry about who's on first and what's on second. And stop saying that they won't let me and they won't let me. You are greater than they. You're greater than you. You're greater than 100,000 days, just one of you, because you are a child of God and you have the consuming fire burning on the inside, and what's on the inside must be let out on the outside so that your consuming fire can consume everything around you and make your way better than it was before you accepted Christ. Barbara turned to Big O and touch Big O and ask, and just touch him. If your fingers don't get burned, then touch him, Barbara. Touch him. Psst. Charles, touch him. Psst. Now, if it's not sizzling fire, then maybe you got your burner down too low. Here's what I want you to do. Stand on your feet as I give the invitation. And I give the benediction. Watch this. I want you to lift up your arms. Please. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary. Lift up your arms. And now, I want you to ask God for a double portion anointing. Now, this double portion, this intense anointing, is called the unction of the Holy Spirit. The unction is an intensified baptism of the Spirit. The unction is an intensified Spirit. And he will give it to you freely if you desired. Lord, give me a double portion. Give me the unction of your Spirit. Let it burn afresh in my life.
fan the floor in your temple, which is my body. Fan the floor, Father, purified and sanctified, and then set it ablaze all over again. I know, Father, and I've been taught and I heard today that you are a consuming fire, but you'll never burn me up. Your consuming fire burns up for everything that shouldn't be in me or upon me. So right now, Father, let your consuming fire intensify. Now, Father, replace stuff with your presence. Replace illness with your healing. Replace poverty with your prosperity. Replace need with more than enough. Replace worry with peace. Defeat cancer. Defeat high blood pressure. Burn up high blood pressure. Burn up heart problems. Burn up even arthritis. Burn up lupus. Burn up. Replace loneliness with closer than a brother. Father, I receive your double portion. I receive your unction right now. I receive your unction right now, Father. And Lord, while you're walking around in me, if you see anything that shouldn't be there, Lord, eradicate it and replace it with your very power and your very presence. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Jehovah God, I feel the fire. Jehovah God, I feel the fire. Jehovah God, just before the benediction, I want the blazing fire and the anointing to come like a mighty rushing wind. Lord, there's some smoke smothering in the place. Father, this house is, there's some smoke smothering in this house. I feel the fire. Move in a magnificent way, Father. I feel your presence, Father, I know. I know that you're making it happen, Father. Thank you, Lord. I feel the fire. I feel the fire. I feel the fire. Oh, Lord, I feel the fire. Oh, Lord, I feel the fire. Consume me, Lord, consume me, Lord, consume me, Lord. Fire.
We give an invitation to discipleship. If you're not saved, come. You come by seeking salvation. You come by letter, Christian experience. Candidate for baptism, however you come, come now. You may come under respiration. Restoration means that you're restoring your membership. You may come watch care, meaning that you don't know yet how long you'll be in the area you're seeking covering. Hug this saint next to you. If somebody's crying next to you, don't let them, you don't know whether it's tears of joy or tears of anguish. If you see the tears, then anointing.
I feel the fire.
We thank you.
I feel the fire.
We thank you for the volcano on the inside.
I feel the fire.
We thank you for the eruption of the.
I feel the fire.
Oh, I feel the fire.
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 I feel the fire. Somebody by the hand and see if you can join fire. See if your fire will. See if your fire. See if your fire. See if your fire. See if your fire will intensify their fire. See if your fire will intensify their fire. See if your fire will intensify their fire right now. the fire.
We have the fire.
Oh God, we have the fire now.
We have the fire.
Satan, you should have put us out.
We have the fire.
You should have quenched the fire.
We have the fire.
Before we got a double portion.
We have the fire.
It's too late now, Satan.
We have the fire.
It's too late because the unction has fallen.
We have the fire.
It's too late because the unction is upon us right now.
We have the fire.
It's too late because the unction is upon us right now.
We have the fire.
It's too late, Charlie, because the unction is flowing right now.
Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire.
Yeah.
Holy Ghost fire.
Hey.
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 Holy Ghost fire.
Hey. Look at heaven. For the benediction, not from the fire, but from this worship. Benediction from this worship service, but not from the fire. Remember, the fire is on the inside. The volcano is waiting to erupt. Some of you have removed the cap off the volcano, and it's erupting today. Some of you are almost there. But when you get to the parking lot,
thank you for the fire.
When you get in your car, let it erupt.
Thank you for the fire.
Uh-huh.
Thank you for the fire.
Thank you for the fire.
Thank you for the fire.
Sanctified fire.
Sanctified fire.
Burning fire.
Burning fire.
Consuming fire.
Consuming fire.
Healing fire. Prosperity fire.
Prosperity fire.
Emotional fire.
Emotional fire.
Sanctified fire.
Sanctified fire.
Intensified fire.
Intensified fire.
Glorious fire.
Glorious fire.
Hallelujah fire.
Hallelujah fire.
Hallelujah fire.
Hallelujah fire.
Hallelujah fire. Yeah. Look at the heaven for the benediction. You know it's not over until God said it's over. This saint of God coming to us from Berean Baptist Church, Christian Experience, she's coming to unite today. Christian Experience, welcome home. Now we'll do the benediction, I think. I think we're going to do the benediction now. Church is on fire.
The 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 church is on fire. The church is on fire. The church is on fire.
The choir is on fire.
The choir is on fire.
Musicians are on fire.
The musicians on fire.
Musicians on fire.
On fire.
Play that fire, musicians.
Play that fire.
Play it, musicians.
Play that fire.
Play it, musicians.
Play
it with fire.
Play it with fire.
Play it with fire.
Play it with fire.
God says, I'm going to do the benediction for real this time. Little Jazz, I've known her since she was born. It's Jerry Green's grandbaby. I knew her when she was a baby. How old are you now, Jazz? She's 11 now. She comes a candidate for baptism. She was raised by a God-fearing grandmother. When the church is on fire, things happen. Don't you take any ill, anything hurting, anything a problem, anything concern out of here today. The consuming fire will burn it to crisp. Don't you take it out. Only thing you take out of here is fire. Throw your worries on the floor. Throw your concerns on. Throw your illness. Throw your need on the floor.
The church is on fire.
Look into heaven for the benediction for real. Y'all can stand up for real. I'm trying to get out of here. Y'all keep messing with me. trying to get out of here. Stretch. Trying to let you go. 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 For real though. This is a benediction for real though. This is for real though. Huh? Another one has come? Y'all keep messing with me, eh?
Another one is coming. Church. Church home. This is my niece. I knew her before she was born. She was in her mother's womb. She's coming as a candidate for baptism as well. If you're not convinced that the church is on fire now, you'll be convinced in a minute. I've done the benediction. Fox, I've done the benediction 6 times. You don't believe that church is on fire. When the church is on fire, God does what he want to do. He does what he want to do, when he want to do it, every time he want to do it, when he want to do it, where he want to do it, he will do it. He will do it. He will do it. Okay. To that same sweet Jesus who was manifested in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, and received in glory, may bless these his children now, henceforth, and for. Oh, come on, shout it evermore. God bless you. Come on with the fire, Holy Ghost fire, glorious fire. Glory, glory, glory.